All right, so we are going to get started. Thank you all for coming. This is our first PI professional event, and we are very excited to be hosting this night. So my name's Emily, and I'm the president of the Forensic Science Society. And on behalf of the society, I'm going to read something that one of Renee's friends actually gave to us with a little bit of a blurb about her, because she is the reason that we are here today. So without further ado, Renee Beliveau was a fourth-year concurrent education student here at Trent, pursuing her passion of teaching French and environmental science. Renee was a member of the Lady Eden College community and even participated in an exchange to study in France during her third year, where she was able to expand her cultural knowledge and visit many remarkable destinations in Europe. Many can agree that Renee had the ability to make everyone feel welcome with her selfless, driven, and sincere personality. Unfortunately, her remarkable life was cut far too short after a fatal incident that occurred in September, which evidently had a significant impact on her friends and loved ones. A scholarship fund has been created in her honor and has recently surpassed $10,000, thanks to generous donations from various friends, family, and even strangers. Although she is no longer with us, Renee's memory and spirit continues to shine through the overwhelming support within the Trent community. All right, so we actually have the president of the university, Leo Groarke, here today, and I'm just gonna ask him at this point to come give a few words before we begin.
That's great, Emily, and I guess I'm here to thank you for the opportunity, I think, to participate in this event. And I will say that there's one thing I've been trying to figure out. So I agreed to participate, and Emily occasionally sent out updates of, you know, how much money was collected for particular people. And I couldn't figure out how to interpret the data that we received, you know. Is it a sign of popularity that you have a lot of people buying tickets? Or does it go the other way around? And I have here, this was the results up to about a day ago. And I'll tell you that this didn't help very much, because at the very top of the list, we have Adam Hopkins, who has to be one of the most popular people at the university. And that's $322.50 at that point. But then at the bottom of the list is Michael Eamon, who's one of the most popular people at the university, and his total is 25 cents. And I believe that was put in by Janine, his wife. So anyway, I'm very comfortable. I landed sort of comfortably in the middle with a whole bunch of other people. But let me end by just being a little bit serious and saying that I really do appreciate the chance to participate in this. It's great to remember Renee. It's a great cause. And I think getting together to support the forensics program, which is actually quite a remarkable program at the university, is something well worth doing, and building the scholarship will help build the future and support students. So I'm tempted to keep talking, because the longer I keep talking, the further away I am from this. But at this point, I'll give it, I think it's to Barry. I'll pass the microphone on to Barry.
Okay, none of this can be done. I don't know if I can use this mic. None of this.
We'll be right back.
by the way, Adam. So I would like to personally thank everybody for putting their name in. I think we've done a great job of raising money under the tutelage of the Forensic Science Society, and I just want to give a round of applause to everybody. Thank you. Now, if you can remember the order you came up in, that's the order you're going to get pied in. So please go back to your seat.
Let's get this party started.
Yeah.
Oh my God, take off the hat. Take off the hat.
Oh my goodness.
We have more paper towels?
Yes.
Our photographer Chase.
Hopefully, we're going to have a great time. And the kids. And, have a great night. Yeah, I gotta like bump it up a little. Make sure you give this man a lot.
Good job, guys.
Poetry, no one seemed to notice me. Being young was getting so old. Cheap beer and cigarettes, life was like a movie set, and I seemed to be given no role. But in times of trouble, I can turn to my mother, and I know that she gon' understand. So at age 18, I cried to my mother, and she told me, young man, there are moments when you fall to the ground, but you are stronger than you feel. So loud.